Hi, hello everybody. I am Dr. Dias Thavre. Now I share the screen of today's lecture in front of you. Please wait. Welcome to the seventh lecture of course number PAP 365. Title of this course, Diseases of Field and Horticultural Crops and Their Management Second. Okay. So in today's lecture, we will discuss about which disease generally seen in the sugar canes. Okay, so sugar cane on which number of the fungal disease, bacterial disease and some viral disease are also seen. Okay, so out of these diseases seen in the sugar cane, already we discussed the one disease in lecture that is smut diseases seen in the field crops, that is a weep smut of sugar canes. Okay, so in this lecture we discuss about remaining diseases seen in the sugar cane, especially some symptoms developed due to the fungi and also the mycoplasma like organisms. Okay, so this is the most important disease seen in the sugarcane, that is known as the red rot of sugarcane. Okay, so these pathogens infect to the leaf portion as well as the cane portion of the sugarcane plants. Means initially just dark red spots seen on the midrib portion of the leaf. Okay, so these dark red lesions become elongated and spread towards the midrib portion of the leaf. Okay, means in most favorable condition or in the advanced diseased conditions, these red lesions generally spread towards the entire surface of the or entire surface of the midrib portion of this leaf. Means in last stage of the infection, these midrib become dark red in color or just a blood color midribs are seen. Okay, but final stage of this infection, this dark red color turns to the black in color. Means this black color represent as a formation of the acerbellae spore fruits already developed inside these infected lesions. Okay, so in this way the infected leaf become withers, dries. Okay, means crown points or crown or growth means crown points of the sugarcane plants become withers, and these infected plants may or may not be dies totally. Okay, so this symptom generally seen on the leaf portion. Then you see these symptoms on also the sugarcane plants. Means you can tag the cross section vertically of the infected sugarcane plants and see this vascular bundle cells. So this vascular bundle cells is totally discolored in nature. Means this whitish pithy tissue become red in color. Means dark red lesions may be seen or growth in vertically positions inside this infected cane. Okay, so in this way number of the blackish lesions, this reddish lesions is just spread in vertically position or just spread in outward as well as the downward directions. So in this way the this pithy tissue is totally discolored in nature. Or in last stage of the infection, this red tissue become black in color. Means this black color represent as a formation of the acerbellae spore fruits. Okay, sometimes these infected lesions shows the halo ring or just a large cavity is also seen inside this infected cane portion of the sugar canes. Okay, so in this way the pithy tissue is totally discolored, means retard the quality of the juice as well as reduce the yield of that sugarcane fields. Okay, so this is the major disease seen in the sugarcane plants or sugarcane fields. But this disease not seen in the Maharashtra state. But nowadays, means recently, last 2 years, these red rot symptoms also be seen in the some tracts of the Satara districts in near about the Nira rivers. Okay. Then causal organism, that is a Colototrichum falciatum and glomerular tucumensis, means Colototrichum falciatum, this is the imperfect stage, or this is the asexual stage of this fungus, means in this case the asexual spores is produced, that is known as the conidia. Means this red color means after pathogen infect to that leaf or inside the canes, so this tissue become red in color, and finally this red color turns to the black in color. Means this black color represent, or this black color our lesions on which these asexual spore fruits are produced, and this asexual spore fruit is known as the acerbalized spore fruits. So this acerbalized spore fruits generally lies on the infected lesions. So this acerbalized develop or produces the spores and spore bearing hyphae along with the black city. Okay, so this black city is always larger than this conidiophore. Okay, so this conidiophore generally arise from this infected lesions. So at the tip of this conidiophore, number of the conidia is produced, and this conidia disseminated from this infected lesions and fall down or deposit on the healthy one host tissue of the leaf, or maybe on the surface of the sugarcane plant. So this healthy one plants become infected. Means in this way, secondary infection generally takes place through this conidia spread by means of the wind or air currents. Okay, means this conidia is single celled, haline, falciate, and somewhat granular in shape. Okay. Then second case, that is a perfect stage of this fungus, that is a glomerular tucumensis. So in this case, the fungus produces the sexual spore fruit. This sexual spore fruit is known as the Paralithecia. Means a flask-shaped Paralithecia sexual spore fruit is produced. So inside this spore fruit, the ascite generally lies or formed or produced at the bottom side of this flask-shaped Paralithecia. So single ascite having the ascospores are produced. So this is the single ascospores, or this ascospores generally produce within this single ascite. So number of the ascite just lies or produced at this bottom side of this Paralithecia spore fruits. Means in this case, sexual spores is produced by forming the sexual spore fruit, that is known as the Paralithecia. Means inside the Paralithecia, sexual ascospores are produced. Means primary infection takes place through ascospore present in the infected plant parts, debris in the soil. And secondary infection always takes place through asexual spore, that is through conidia. Okay, so this is the disease cycle of the Colototrichum falciatum. Means this is the infected plants having the some leaf or stem portion become infected. Okay, so in this way, this conidia generally produced within this acerbalized spore fruits, and this conidia disseminated from this place and again infect to the healthy one sugarcane plants. So in this way spread the disease from one plant to the another plant. And primary infection means after harvest, some crop residues or leaves or whole plants debris in the soil, means these infected stubbles generally is having the pathogen survival for long time in particularly soil. After favorable conditions, these infected stubbles having the pathogen become active and produce the ascospores, and this ascospore directly infect to growing these sugarcane plants. Okay, so in this way, primary infection generally takes place. Okay, then control measures means removal and destruction of the affected plant parts or infected stubbles and trusses, collect from this field and burn properly. Then deep tillage to incorporate the infected plant parts left over the on the lands. Then adopt crop rotation by including rice or any green manuring crop, because these climatospores or some fungi may be survival in the soil for long durations. Then select the sites from disease free fields, because primary infection takes place through use of the infected sites for planting purpose. Then avoid the rotuning of the diseased crop. Okay, suppose rotun practice followed by the farmers. So this red rot symptoms is majorly seen in the rotun crop as compared to the seasonable or fresh planted sugarcane plants. Then avoid the flow of irrigation water from infected, diseased, affected field to the healthy sugarcane field, because this number of infected leaf generally fallen on the land. So this blackish color or blackish fungus may be float on the surface of the water. So in this way, spread the disease from one place to the another place, or this infected canes having the some fungus are produced. So suppose these canes having some artificial injury generally seen. So this fungus may be mixed with this water. So in this way, spread the disease from one place to the another place. Then avoid the primary infection takes place through infected seeds. So these seeds generally tilted in hot water having the temperature 52 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes, followed by dipping in 0.1% carbendazim solution for 20 minutes before the planting, because these sugarcane seeds already infected, and this seeds is used for planting purpose, so 100% disease is produced. Then this seeds is again treated with the aerated steam therapy at 52 degrees Celsius for 4 to 5 hours. Then growing resistant varieties, that is Sanjivani, then other this resist variety grown by the farmers against these red rot symptoms. Then application of the biocontrol agent, for example Trichoderma, has shown the promise in the containment of the disease through antibiosis and induced systemic resistance. Means this Trichoderma acts as a biocontrol agent to inhibit the growth of the Colototricum halkatum. Okay, so in this way you can avoid the red rot symptoms seen in the sugarcane crops. Then this is the most important disease recently seen in sugarcane, and this symptom is known as the pokwa boing disease. Okay, so this disease generally seen in two stage. First stage, that is a chloratic phase, and second one is the knife cut phase. Okay, means in first stage, that is generally infected plants having the leaf located at the basal portion of the plants. So this basal portion having the leaf, so this leaf generally chloratic in nature, means chloratic patches towards the base of the younger plants. Okay, so this leaf is totally yellow in colors, and this leaf produces from the infected canes become shorter in appearance, means shortening the top leaf generally produced from these infected plants. Means chlorosis at the base of the younger leaves, and somehow these ladder-like longitudinal breaks generally seen in the rind portion of the sugarcane plants. Okay, means this base of the infected plants or base of the affected leaf is often narrow as compared to the normal leaf. Okay, means under field conditions, this disease develop many variation from general symptoms. But the this infected plants is also malformed, twisted top or damaged stalks. Means in look at these pictures. This is the first phase, that is a chlorotic phase. Means a chlorotic phase and chlorotic phase second, in which the base portion or basal side of the young leaf is generally infected and generally yellow in color. Means these chlorotic leaf become narrow, means produces in narrow size as compared to the healthy one leaf. Okay, then second phase of these pathogens. So this growing points is also infected, means the new top portion or grows away normally and continue to make the cane. Means in severe conditions or in some varieties, the stalks of mature cane is also infected by this fungus. Okay, means some knife-like cuts generally seen on the cane portion or internode portion of these sugarcane plants. Okay, means in second phase, knife cut phase. Okay, so this phase in which some ladder-like infections seen on the internode portion, means the some stalk of this mature cane having the knife like cut are seen on the portion of the internodes. Okay, so in this way some knife cut phase generally seen. Okay, so first phase chlorotic phase and second one knife cut phase. Okay, means knife cut symptoms of the disease reported in several varieties. For example, Coimbatore 671 or Coimbatore 8014, means the number of the variety suffer this cocoboing disease. Okay. Okay, so this is the chlorotic phase, this is the acute phase or top rot phase. Means a growing portion of the sugarcane plants is totally rotted and just a ladder-like knife cut are seen on this growing portion. So this plant is totally affected by this fungus. So these infected plants cannot develop the canes. Means retard the height of these plants, only produces the shoots. Okay, so this is the red streaking and chlorosis symptoms are seen in picture number first. Then in second case, the growing points of the or growing portion of the sugarcane plants is totally rotted. Means this is known as the stalk rots. And in figure number or picture number three, that is a knife cut and deformed top portion generally seen on the infected sugarcane plants. Okay, so this is the malformed and distorted leaf seen on the growing portion of the sugarcane plants. Then causal organism Fusarium monoliformi. So this Fusarium monoliformi reproduced by asexually by forming the asexual spore fruit. Okay, so this asexual spore fruits produce the mycelia and also the conidia. Means in Fusarium, two type of the conidia are produced. One is the microconidia and macroconidia. Or in advanced or unfavorable conditions, this fungus also be develop the chlamydospores instead of the sexual, instead of this conidia. Okay, so this is the macroconidia and this is the microconidia. Perpetuations means the dormant mycelium persist in the ratoon crops or infected sugarcane plants. And secondary transmission generally takes place through conidia, through infected seeds or irrigation water or flashes, rains and soil. Okay, so this fusarium having the wide host range instead with the sugarcane plants. Okay, then the control measures, this infected plants is rogue out from these fields or select, means locate the infected plants and burn properly. Then planting of the healthy one sites material, means check whether the disease is seen on the sugarcane fields for selection of the planting materials. Then use of the resistant varieties. Then spraying with 0.1% carbon enzyme or 0.2% copper oxychloride or 0.3% mancozeb. So this is the most important fungicides or most effective fungicide for reducing the coca bean disease. Means near about 2 to 3 sprays is necessary with an interval of 15 days to reduce the multiplication of the pathogen and losses in yield and quality of the also sugar canes. Okay, then next disease seen in the sugar cane, but this disease generally seen due to the mycoplasma, not due to the fungi. Okay, gratia shoot. Means this infected sugarcane plant produces the grass-like plants or just the number of the tillers is comes out from a single infected buds from the sugarcane sets. So this is the means this disease is known as the grass issue. Means normal healthy one plant produces the 1 or 2 tillers. But infected sugarcane plant produces the maximum tillers from a single bud. So that's why this disease is known as the gratia shoot. Means produce the plants looks like as a grass appearance. Okay, so use this is the infected sugarcane younger plants due to the mycoplasma like organisms. Means these infected plants is generally seen the height, means retard the growth of these plants. Okay, then you see this individual infected younger plants. So this chloratic leaf is produced from these infected buds or from the sugarcane sets. Okay, means this grassy shoot appearance symptoms generally seen 1 or 2 month old seedlings of the sugarcane up to 3 to 4 month old plants. So initially chloratic or partially chloratic leaf generally seen in the infected plants. Okay, so retard the height or stunted the growth of these plants. Okay, means production of the number of the thin tillers from this infected single buds. Means this infected plants produces the number of thin tillers, and these thin tillers or size of the produced leaf generally narrow or small as compared to the healthy one plant, and this leaf or diseased leaf generally yellow in color. Means a chloratic leaf is produced from these infected buds of a sugarcane seeds. Okay, so in this way this disease means suppose the early infection of this mycoplasma seen on the sugarcane seedlings. So these sugarcane seedlings having the leaf is totally dries and withers and not develop any mature canes. But after 3 to 4 month old plant, the infection generally seen. So this sugarcane infected plant produces the mature cane, but the height of this cane is also retarded as compared to the normal plants, and this reduces the node size of this infected cane. Okay, so this is the symptoms generally develop due to the mycoplasma like organism or phytoplasma on the sugarcane plants. Okay, so you just see these three photographs regarding the grassy shoot symptoms. I mean, just a grass like plant is produced from the infected birds of the cells. Okay, so this is the just a grass like sugarcane plants produced from the single birds. Okay, then etiological parts of this mycoplasma like organism. So this mycoplasma like organism or phytoplasma, these pathogens generally present or survival on the sewage cells or sewage tube within the infected sugarcane cells. Means this pathogen mainly present in the phloem cells or sewage cells of the host tissues. Okay, so that's why this phloem tissue is totally blocking by movement of the carbohydrate material and other food material or water from one plant to the another plants. Okay, so this mycoplasma or phytoplasma having the bodies generally noticed in two types. One is the spherical bodies and second is the filamentous bodies, varying the size of particularly spherical body 300 to 400 nanometer, and filamentous bodies that is 30 to 53 micrometer in diameters. Okay, so this disease generally spread through use of the infected planting material, because in planting material means in sugarcane sets, the phloem cells is already infected and survival these mycoplasma. Okay, so this planting material is used for sowing purpose, so 100% disease is produced. Then this sap like or infected saps generally spread from one place to the another place with the help of the insect vector, that is some aphid species and some leaf hopper species. Okay, means transmission means transmit the disease from one place to the another place. Means transmission of this grassy shoot disease mainly takes place through leaf hopper and aphid species. Okay, then this in the absence of the sugarcane plants, the sorghum also serve as a natural collateral host for this grassy shoot disease, causing the mycoplasma like organism or phytoplasma like organisms. Okay, then control measures, eradicating the diseased clumps and canes, then use the healthy one canes or healthy one sets for planting purpose, then rotten practice means avoid the rotten practices, then sets treated with hot water treatments or some hot air stain therapy treatment, or these sugarcane sets also be deep in fungicide solution, that is a 0.1% carbendazim solution for 15 minutes, or spraying with Metasystis or Folidon, means any systemic fungicides generally sprays over these sugarcane fields or sugarcane plants to control the population of the aphids and also the jessies, means to control the transmission of the disease from one place to the another place by means of the any sucking pest. So control this sucking pest by using the any systemic insecticide at the rate of 0.05%. Okay, and last disease seen in the sugarcane, that is a rotten stunting of sugarcanes. Okay, so this rotten stunting disease generally produced due to the bacteria that is a Clavibacter xyli, Horma species xyli. Okay, so Clavibacter xyli, this is the bacteria species. So this rotten stunting disease generally seen in the sugarcane plants and produces the external symptoms as well as the internal symptoms. Means on the external symptoms, generally infected sets is planted in the main fields. So after infection, the slow germinate these buds. This is the main character symptoms generally seen due to the bacteria, that is a slow germination, then slow growth of the plant as compared to the healthy one plants. Okay, so these infected plants also retard the height of the plants, and this infected plants is easily identified because you can see this sugarcane fields at longer distance. So up and down or uneven sugarcane plant is seen. Okay, means up and down appearance of the plants seen in the sugarcane fields means stunting and unthrifty growth of the bacteria mainly seen on the sugarcane plants. So this is the external symptom. External symptoms means just retard the height of the plant, also reduce the germination percentage, then also reduce the or slow growth of the plant. So this is the mainly three symptoms seen as external symptoms. Then you can see this internal symptoms. Okay, means take the cross section of the infected sugarcane plants and see the internal bundle cells. Okay, vascular bundle cells means this vascular bundle cells is discolored within the individual vascular bundle cells. Means this discoloration may be vary from variety to the variety. Means this portion of the stalk or skin is show small reddish dots or reddish dot comma like structure. So you can see this comma like structure seen inside this infected stalks. So you cannot see in the comma like structure seen in the red rot symptoms as well as the wilt symptoms, but in case of the rotten stunting, the red color means reddish dot comma like structures are seen. Okay, means a node of the every angiocans have a pink color near to the meristems. Means meristems tissue generally pink in color, and inside this meristem tissue, the vascular tissue is totally discolored, maybe reddish color with comma like structures are seen. Okay, so this orange red vascular bundles generally plug the xylem and phloem cells by producing some gummy substances. Means gummy substances also seen in the xylem cells. So these xylem cells totally block in nature and translocate, means stop the translocate the water from one place to the another place. Means disease like clump usually stunted growth, reduced the tillering or number of the tillers, then thin tillers produced from the infected plants with shortening the internode portion, and this infected plant having the leaf, so this leaf or foliage is totally yellow in color. So this is the general overall symptoms seen on the external of the plant as well as the inner side of the sugarcane sets. Okay, so this is the healthy one plots of the sugarcane, and this is the infected sugarcane field or plot by the bacteria. Okay, so you see this just a comma like vascular bundle cells generally red in colors. Okay, Clavipacter xylee, former species xylee. So this bacteria mainly present on the xylem cells of the infected plants. So this Clavibacter is a small rod shape, gram positive in nature, the non-acid forming bacteria, no any endospores are formed, and pleomorphic bacteria. Pleomorphic bacteria means this bacteria having no any particular shapes. Depends, means the shape of the bacteria or shape of the cells is changed according to the positions or according to the criteria or according to the general positions. So pleomorphic bacteria generally known, that is known as the Clavibacter. Then perpetuation means use of the diseased sets for planting purpose. Then mechanical transmission by sets cutting means suppose at the time of the making these sets from the sugarcane plants, so you use the cutters or sharp cutters or knife. Okay, so these cells have generally stick on the surface of the cutters, and this cutter is also used for another the healthy one sugarcane plants. So in this way mechanically transmit this bacteria from one plant to the another plant, or harvested implements is also mainly responsible for spread the disease. Then the collateral host, for example, maize, sorghum, sudan grass, cynodon dactylon. So some weed species as well as some cereals crops also acts as a collateral host for surviving the bacteria in the absence of the sugarcane plants. Then control measures, select the healthy one sets from healthy one sugarcane fields, then remove and burn the clumps showing the diseased incidence or disease portions, then treat the sets with hot waters or hot air steam therapy, or avoid the transmission of bacteria from one place field to the another field with the using the agriculture implements, for example, knives, cutters, or other parts of the machine. So this before the actual use of this knife, cutters, or other equipments, just disinfect or just deep in the caustic soda or deep in the 1%, 0.1% benzoate or sodium chloride for 5%. Means disinfect this agricultural implements before the actual use in the sugarcane fields. Then application of the ammonium sulfate to sugarcane crop, so reduce the disease incidence and increase the yield. Means ammonium sulfate generally used as a fertilizer to sugarcane crops. So you can also reduce the incidence and yield of the, means increase the yield by applying the ammonium sulfate to sugarcane crops. Okay, so this is the information about the different diseases seen in the sugarcane, means whip smut, then wilt disease. So these two diseases already seen in the previous lecture, but in today's lecture we discussed about only the red rot disease, then pokka boing disease, then grassy shoot disease, then ratoon stunting disease. Okay, so keep in your mind about this today's lectures. Okay, so any doubt, please contact to me personally. Okay, so here now I stop my today's lecture.